Hi, I'm Jan from Velomobile World. Last time we made a video about adjustment of track, and then somebody made the comments, yeah, but there's also another method how to do it. So we came out here on a slightly hill, and I want to show you how we do it. There's the factory, and as you can see, we're in the middle of nowhere in a very beautiful landscape of Romania. These are the tools we need to make it, and I will show you how to do it. So before I make this test, I check three things. First one is, are my brakes are coming completely loose? The second is tire pressure. So I check if there is on good pressure. I drive mostly here with 6 bar because the roads are pretty rough. And I don't like so much having a very bumpy ride. I know 6 is not ideal yet for rolling resistance, but if I put left and right both 6 bar, it doesn't matter. So the third thing is what I do, I measure the track. So I measure the front side and the rear side. And I measured in above approximately the same height. So I know if I start with an approximately perfect track. Check always if there's no heavy things inside the bike, because if it can roll and then damage your shell. So that's not funny. Yeah, we have really rough roads, so I have some scratches underneath. So I measure here approximately the middle of the tire, and here the middle of the tire. By me it's equal. If not, you can take the ball joint off and adjust it here. I will show you later how to do that one. So I brought some chalk with me, and I take the middle point of my axle and write start here. So I know I start from here every time on the same spot, and I let it roll until it fully stops. Don't cycle. We have today really great weather because there's no wind, so that doesn't influence it. I will not go very high speeds, because if I go high speeds rolling down, aerodynamic will get a big role in how far you come. You want to test only the rolling resistance. So you don't want to make high speeds. Yeah, let's start. So I took down my legs from the pedals to make 100% sure I don't push a bit, and I just release the brakes and I let it roll until it stops. So the easiest is to take down the wheel, because you can come very easy on that spot. That looks crap. So I take down this one. And if you put it back on the end, put some Loctite 243 on this one to make sure that it's 100% secured. Although it's already here, you have fillet, and there you have fillet, so you have already encounter force. But still, I prefer to have also an Loctite on it. So I take this down. And I go, for example, one fillet in, or half fillet we can do with Alpha 7, because we can So I didn't bring the right key with me. I should bring the 11 here. I thought I need to bring a 10, but I managed to get this off anyhow. And now I go 1.5 fillet in, and I put it back. Then I repeat the same test at least twice, because to verify if the test is proper. If you have two times exactly on the same spot, that's really perfect, but that's not gonna happen. So you need to take an average from the test with the same settings. So you do every setting, you do at least two times, and you write down at the lines which settings you had. So it's practical. What I do, I measure from the bowl head until from the bowl head to there, and then I measure how much millimeter that is, and I write it down at the result line. Otherwise, you will probably have like 8 test runs, and you don't know anymore which result was from which line. So now we readjust this one. I will only tie this a little bit with the hand, not too much, because probably there's a big chance I have to take it off anyway to do more tests. So this test takes a while before you did it, because you do it every test run, you do it 2 times. But normally you don't need to redo this again, although unless you hit a very big pothole and you bend something. Otherwise this setting will be for a long time good. So you spend some time now in checking it and adjusting it, and then after it's as I said, you don't need to do it again, and it saves you a lot of energy and tire wear. So let's do the test again. So this was with the same setting, and I arrive really, really close to the same spot. So I know this is approximately pretty good test in the middle. So this is the middle from that test. Then we go up again and we adjust the track and repeat this again. And then probably I will come farther away, then I know the track was better, or I will go less far, so I know I went the wrong way. So this you repeat quite a couple of times before you have the perfect setting. As I said already, uphill, this might take a while before you really find the perfect setting for you. Have fun, see you next time.